Welcome to the Yas Marina Circuit for the finale of another thrilling Formula One season. It's been a breathtaking year, and we end it at a track that's been the scene of many glories and heartbreaks over its history. It's time to end the season in style. It's time for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The Yas Marina Circuit, just over 3.4 miles long with 21 corners and two very long back straights. There are two DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both Turn 8 and Turn 11, and offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners as well, in particular 15, 16 and 17, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into Turn 1?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into Turn 1 as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, De Vries, Charles Leclerc and Norris, Verstappen, Mick Schumacher, Vettel and Yuki Tsunoda, Gasly, Russell, Nicholas Latifi and Stroll, Giovinazzi, Fernando Alonso. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Guan Yu Zhou and Nikita Mazepin. Ocon, they've taken a grid penalty. And Sergio Perez completes our grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
There's still a chance we can win this championship, so go out there and bring back the title. Virtual safety car has just been deployed due to Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Green flag. The fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Confirmed. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. Lewis is in for his stop. Go, go, go. You'll be racing on the exit. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Some information on Russell. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there is no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Okay, clear. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. Behind is 1.9 seconds. The stewards have now enabled DRS. DRS is now online. Some information on Giovinazzi. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car.
We'll be right back.
There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap. Green flag. We're starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. gap to the car behind is 1.6 seconds. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, clear. Some information on Ocon. They are out of the race. Gave it your best, but it just wasn't our day today. It's been an incredible season. We'll come back stronger next year.
And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers Champion. Victory today then, but bittersweet emotions I'm sure as the championship slips through their fingers. Even so, what a fantastic final race of the season this was. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, staying out of trouble is probably the most important factor here. In the race where half the field weren't classified at the chequered flag, you were able to guarantee a good result by basically keeping the car running. With their pace and a decent strategy as well, I don't think the race was ever really in doubt.
As the winners make their way up to the podium, one can only imagine the celebrations that will take place at McLaren tonight. Congratulations to everyone on the team securing the win and proving they're a force to be reckoned with out on the track. After an incredible performance, Lewis Hamilton secures the top spot in the Drivers' Championship. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Nikita Mazepin gets my vote today.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they manage to secure the Constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. It's always good to have someone in your team take the championship, but how does it feel for that person to be your teammate? You're no longer in the top spot. Are you hoping to regain it? Are you happy with your performance today? Is there anything that you think gave you the edge over your rivals? Great! Well, that's everything.